What's going on, guys? It's Sam, and today I'm going to show you how to create an animated drop a like button in Adobe Premiere Pro. In this tutorial, you'll learn how to create a thumbs up motion graphics template, how to animate the like button, and how to use the motion graphics template all in Adobe Premiere Pro. Alright guys, as always, you can download this animation as a template by clicking the link in the description. You can go ahead and get that like button and you can skip this whole tutorial. Alright guys, so let's go ahead and dive in. First thing we want to make sure that we have open is the Essential Graphics panel, which I've got open here on the left side. You can go under Window and you can go ahead and turn it on just like that. So in the Essential Graphics panel, we want to make sure that before we start creating our like button, we have a good thumbs up. Okay, so if we just go to Google and we just type in YouTube thumbs up, then we'll see a bunch of different thumbs ups and like buttons. I've used this one. I've also used this one before. If you right click it, go to open image and new tab. It's got a white background. I usually go into Photoshop and I remove the background. If you don't know how to do that, just go ahead and let me know in the comments. I will teach you how to do it, and also maybe I'll make a video on it for you. So yeah, just let me know if you don't know how to remove a background in Photoshop, and we can do that. But yeah, I already removed the background on this, so I'm just gonna go ahead and use the file that I've already created, okay? So under Essential Graphics, we're gonna click on this new layer button, okay? And we're gonna click on the From File option. And with that, we see my thumbs up. It's transparent, doesn't have a white background. So let's hit open. Okay, and we'll see that we have a graphic here. Here, let me just scoot it to the beginning of the timeline, okay? So we've got our thumbs up, all right? And we'll see in the Essential Graphics panel, it says layer one up top. Let's go ahead and rename that. Call it thumbs up, not thumb up, thumbs up. okay, and let's go ahead and scale it down to the size that we want. So I'm gonna scale it down, let's do like 25, okay? And then also what we wanna do is we want to add some text. So we got some big text here, okay? So let's go ahead and type in drop a like. Okay, we can also do it in all caps. Let's do drop a like. Boom, all caps. Okay, let me, so now that we have the text selected, let's scroll down here. And I've already got the font that I want, but I'm going to bring the size down. Make sure I have it all selected. Bring the size down of all this text so that's not so much bigger than the thumbs up. And then I'll click on the selection tool, kind of reposition it. Okay, but I think I want to make sure everything's in the center. So I want to turn on the safe margins button. Okay, if you don't have that, just click on this button editor plus, and you can drag it right here down into your toolbar. Okay, so I'm gonna click on the safe margin. I'm gonna make sure that this is kind of in the center. So let me also move the thumbs up. So when I click on it, I can just kind of move the position just like that. And just kind of eyeball like if it's in the center. I'll have to move the text again, hold on. Okay, so I think that's pretty good. I just kind of centered it. I'll turn off the save margins now. But yeah, that looks pretty solid. And let's go ahead and start animating, okay? So first thing I wanna do is I wanna animate that thumbs up. Okay, so I'm gonna turn off the text and I'm just gonna have the thumb pop on in the center first, okay? So in order to animate the thumb, let's go to the Effect Controls panel. I'm gonna open up the thumbs up clip and let's change the position, okay? First, I wanna save this position. So I'm just gonna add a keyframe. Then I'm gonna go all the way to the beginning and the normal setting for it is at 960 for the X position. That's like the center of a 1080p. Screen. So now the thumb is back in the center, and while it's in the center, I don't want it to move. So I'm actually going to put another keyframe at 960 here, because I just don't want the thumb to move for the duration that I'm animating it, okay? So if I hit play, you can see it doesn't move, but then it moves to the side for later. So we'll worry about that movement later. But for now, I just want the thumb to pop on and just scale up from nothing. So I'm just gonna hit the scale here and also the rotation, okay? And let's bring the scale down to 0 and maybe the rotation is like negative 60. And then let's hold shift and go to the right once and then let go of shift and go to the right and that goes 6 frames, which is about a fourth of a second because I'm on 24 frames per second. And let's bring the scale back up to 25 and rotation back to 0. So when we play this, bam, the thumb just kind of comes on and then it moves to the left. Alright, so it's pretty cool. And then we can also click on these two keyframes that we put for scale and rotation, set them to ease in so that the movement is a little more smooth, which is pretty nice. Maybe I'll line up these movement keyframes to the side, and then I'm going to ease this out and ease this in for when the drop a like comes on screen. Okay, so right here is where I want the drop a like to come on screen. So as I animated that thumb, right when the thumb gets to its position, I want drop a like to come on. So I'm going to do that by minimizing the source text option. Let's focus on this opacity. Okay, so I'm going to have the opacity start at 0. Let's go shift to the right and then to the right again for 6 frames, 1/4 of a second, and let's type in 100 opacity. Okay, so there we go. So now we have the thumb kind of popping on, moving, and then drop a like shows up. Okay, so I want this to last for most of the graphic, and then I'm gonna wanna have the thumb just kind of like slide over and make drop a like disappear. Okay, it's gonna be a cool effect, and I've already done this in my template, so if you wanna see it, just go ahead and download the template, but we're gonna create it together right now, okay? So first thing I wanna do is we'll just leave the drop a like text on, and I'm just gonna animate the thumb, okay? So let's go ahead and add another keyframe for position. Let's set this to linear so it doesn't mess with any interpolation. Let's go ahead and go 12 frames over. So I'll go shift to the right once, shift to the right once, that's 10 frames, and then go to the right twice without using shift to make 12 frames, which is half a second. So let's move the thumb, and we're gonna go all the way to the right so that it's past the drop a like. And we are also going to, once it gets here, we're going to scale it down and rotate it out again. So I'm gonna make sure these are linear keyframes as well. Okay, so let's go shift to the right once, to the right, so that's 6 frames, and let's scale it down to 0, and let's rotate it to -180. So it just kind of like spins that way. Look at that, okay? And then I'm also going to ease in these keyframes as well. Let's ease out for the scaling and rotation, ease in for the ones on the outside. So when we play it, just like a nice little exit, right? All right, but I'm also going to ease in on this movement and ease out from the beginning. There we go. So it's like, it's nice and like smooth, okay? And so while the thumb is going, I want drop a like to disappear. Okay, so I'm gonna make the thumb go on top of the drop a like. So now you'll see when it moves, it's on top. But as it's going, I want the drop a like to like fade off, okay? So let's go into drop a like and let's add a mask. All right, and then let's make the mask big enough so that it can cover the entire drop a like text. And then I'm also going to feather this. So like as it moves, it's gonna do that, okay? It's just gonna kind of like fade off. So let me just put it like right here, and let's animate it. So let's hit the stopwatch for the mask path, and it's gonna go to the right and it's gonna fade off like right here. So click the mask again and I'll just kind of like pull it off. So then when I go back, you'll see that it's kind of like pushing it, but maybe I need it to finish earlier. Okay, look at that. Oh, it's beautiful. Look at that. The thumbs up just pushes all the text off. Okay, so let's see what this looks like, okay? Ah, look at that. So it pops on, drop a like, and then it pushes it off and flies away. Oh, that's so sick. Okay, hold on. I don't know what that is. Okay, so we play it and it did exactly what we did. All right, guys, so once we've finished our animation, let's go ahead and make that motion graphics template, okay? So let me go ahead and zoom in here. So I'm right clicking on the clip inside of my timeline, and I'm going to go up to export as motion graphics template. So it's gonna bring up this window, all right, for us to name our motion graphics template. It's called drop a like. I'm gonna save it on my local drive. I'm putting it on my desktop, okay? And it's gonna include a video thumbnail, which is great. It shows the preview of what we just made. And then we're gonna add some keywords. I'm gonna put in like par edits, and also drop a like, and also the like button, okay? So that we can search it once we actually add it into our essential graphics panel. So I'm gonna hit okay, and it's going to export it. All right, so it's done. So I'm gonna go to my central graphics panel and go to browse, and we'll see in the very bottom right, there's a install motion graphics template button. So I'm gonna click on that, and we'll see there's the drop a like template, okay? So I'm gonna click on that, and it installed real quick. So I'm gonna type in tar edits to find it, or actually no, I'll type in like button, and we'll see the drop a like template. Look at that. Look, you preview it too. Okay, so then I'm just gonna go to another part of my timeline, and I'm gonna drop it in, and bam. We got the template, all good. I know I did this pretty quickly. I know I did the keyframes pretty fast. It's because I'm very used to it. But I hope everything that I did makes sense. I hope you could follow along. And if you couldn't, you could always just download this template. Link in the description down below. Go ahead and get it yourself. I also want to let you guys know that I'm making these motion graphics all the time in my YouTube Motion Graphics Academy. I have a Facebook group for it right now, so you can go ahead and join that Facebook group. The link is also in the description for the YouTube Motion Graphics Academy. And the last thing I want to leave you guys with is, of course, the next video, which is a YouTube subscribe button. So go and check that out. I know a lot of you guys love it. It's a big fan favorite. So go ahead and download that for your videos, and I will see you in the next one.